Nearly 50 people have been arrested after a night of rioting in North London.
So tired of this news. Everywhere I go, they keep talking about the riots.
I can well imagine.
It's crazy. Why can't they act right?
But perhaps it is good that we see how society has created this sense of disenchantment.
Really? How did society make these thugs set people's homes on fire and steal TVs?
Rather than jump to conclusions about who's involved in the riots, policymakers should take a step back and reflect.
They need to reflect on why there weren't more police there to throw these hooligans in jail.
But you see, that is precisely the problem. We are judging them as individuals when they are acting as part of a group. In the circumstances, it is easy to jump to conclusions about what led young people to cause such destruction. I am not going to make the same mistake, particularly since independent academic research studies, the charity that a colleague of mine is the director of, has a reputation for its evidence-based approach to investigating and understanding these kinds of events. I also know from evidence that there is a growing concern among youth justice professionals that the line adopted by the various governments of the past 30 years in dealing with youth crime is flawed.
So you think the 13-year-old girl who was raped in the riots is actually the perpetrator of some supposed social injustice, and the boy who raped her is her victim?
More precisely, the girl and her family and people in their social class, for not being willing to more equitably share what they have with the disadvantaged.
I don't know where you go to learn to think like that, but maybe it's good that you're in a doctor's office. Hopefully he can help you.
Madam, with all due respect, hatred never got us anywhere.
Seems to be working out pretty well for the rioters.
Well now, why don't you two gang up on me? They are not hooligans, they are the oppressed youth of today. They've been backed into a corner and are crying out for help. If solutions are not tailored to what young people really need, they won't help address what we have seen in the past few days.
Why do you sound like someone I know?
I can assure you we have never met.
Because that's the creep who comes on the radio. From NPR. They interviewed him on Fox. O'Reilly ripped him to pieces.
Phone News edited that segment.
Right.
In America, there's more evidence of the Sarah Palin effect as yet another of her...
Vice President Biden is right about those Tea Partiers, and I'm quite worried that each of them will have blood on their hands if their incendiary rhetoric sparks violence in the streets.
Oh? Maybe if the Tea Partiers were violent, you'd be their cheerleader too.
Really? That's quite an unserious remark.
Unserious? You just sat here with a straight face and told us that the violent miscreants behind the riots were really the victims. As if we should somehow try to feel sorry for them. And how can you go on about being worried that each of the Tea Partiers will have blood on their hands if you believe that people aren't individually responsible for their actions?
I'll tell you how.
Ladies, please. That is quite enough. I understand that neither of you were able to study the natural complexities of the nuance involved here, but I can assure you it all makes perfect sense.
I've been around long enough to know BS when I hear it.
Excuse me, mister, but I have a doctorate in sociology from Columbia, and she's right. The only simpleton here is the one who has subjugated his perception of the world around him to his ideologically driven pipe dream parallel universe where ordinary laws of nature don't apply. I can really see why you work for NPR, and here's a hint. It's not because you're smart.
That's gonna hurt.